So, I was thinking of doing a fragrance haul of six fragrances, but I decided I was going to take them one after the other. So, yeah, guys, I have a review for you guys today after a very long break. For me, I usually just go and come, but I will try and make it very consistent. Before we get right into the review, let's take a quick break. Like I said earlier, I was going to do a fragrance haul, but I decided why not take them one after the other. And the fragrance I'm going to be wearing today is actually a Hugo Boss company, or should I say a Hugo Boss related company. But however, before we get into the review, if you're new to my channel, please subscribe, like, comment, share my videos, as much as you can. And if you're an old subscriber, share, like, comment, follow up with, my channel. I really appreciate that. This is Ambre Oud from the house of Baldessarini, and this is the carton, this is the packaging, and it says here separates the men from the boys. It says here separates the men from the boys. Well, so I got a list of fragrances that I've always wanted to get, for a very long time. And I think it has a part of my list. Well, I'll just keep it as a surprise, but let's focus on Baldessarini. So this Baldessarini is, would I say, an affiliated company with, is affiliated to Hugo Boss, the Hugo Boss company that we all know. And this fragrance is an amber oud-based fragrance. There are not a lot of reviews online about this fragrance because, a lot of reviewers, most of the reviews I watched, were talking about the original Ambre Oud, not the Ambre, sorry, not the original Ambre by Baldessarini, not this Ambre Oud. This Ambre Oud is pretty new. I don't know the year of the release or, a lot of components or the notes breakdown. But what I do know is this is an amber oud-based fragrance, and most of the reviews online have been saying that this fragrance, is boozy, it's amber in nature, it has oud as well. But to my nose, I'll tell you guys what I get. So, first off, I like this bottle, I like the packaging, I like the juice color, I like everything about this fragrance. Like, it sits right with me, like, I love it absolutely. And the best part about this fragrance is that you can pick it up from the cap. You can even shake it and it doesn't drop. It clicks into place. You can hear it clicks into place. And you can pick it up from the cap. You do not have to fear about it dropping. It doesn't drop. So I've been giving this a lot of wearing. I got it last week, Monday. I've been giving it a lot of wearing. As you can see, I've given it a lot of wearing. And try to test the compliment factor, to test, if it's a sexy man fragrance. And so far so good, I've gotten only two compliments on this fragrance. And yeah, I would say one thing for sure, it's not going to be your regular compliment beast or compliment magnet, but this really is a man's fragrance. It's sexy in its own way. So initially when I wore this, or from the very first time when I sprayed this, I did not like it at all. It smelled so oud and skanky oud. It gave me this vibe of, cheap, and it smelled so cheap, it just smelled so ordinary. But over the course of wearing it, the second day of wearing it, I got a compliment from a lady, and she says that this smells or makes me feel like a real man, like a sophisticated man. And I was like, why did she say so? And she was like, that it smells so calming and a little bit different. And to my greatest surprise, she knew what oud was, and she said that this does not contain the kind of oud that, will put you off. It's very subtle. The oud in this is very, very subtle. And that is the beautiful thing about this. Now, the amber in this fragrance would just, it gives you, it's a little bit sweet, but it's very, very airy. Like, it's very airy. The moment you spray it, the very moment you spray it, you just get a little bit of skankiness. And after like maybe 3 to 5 minutes, discontent is off, and you start getting that airy, a little bit sweet amber kind of recall, you know. So what I'm saying is, you know, you get that, you know, light, airy, a little bit sweet amber, then a little bit oud. So you just get oud once in a while, once in a while. But the good side, let me just say, the good side of this fragrance is that it's sophisticated, it's amber based. So if you love amber, you definitely love this one. If you love your oud mild, you definitely love this one. And you know, you love that kind of, you know, fragrance that don't, you know, it's not strong, it's not in your face, it's not that kind of in your face kind of fragrance where, you know, you pass and it's so strong, it's so beastly. No, it's airy, like it's quite clean, but you know, a little bit sweet amber, just, you know, free flowing and, you know, very enjoyable. As the good side to it is, you know, just that it's not as strong. You know, if you're the type of person that doesn't like strong fragrances, it's not strong, it's ambery, it's a little bit sweet, it has a little bit of oud in it, you know, just the right amount of composition, I would say. The downside to this is it doesn't last a very long time. Probably you get like 6 hours tops, 6 hours. But I noticed something that under cooler weathers, it tends to project even better, like it projects a little bit beastly. But under the hot, you know, temperate weather, it's a little bit, you know, it dies down quite faster, and you know, it doesn't really last that long. So you get like maybe 6 hours of, you know, longevity, and you know, projection is pretty minimal. You know, anybody around you can, you know, just get your scent bubble and all of that. I really like the packaging. You know, initially, the truth of the matter that you may not like it from the first buy, but as you keep using it, you get used to it. And I wouldn't advise anybody going, just coming into the fragrance game to actually get this one. This is for people who have experienced a lot of fragrances and, you know, have this style about fragrance and enjoy what fragrance is all about and try to know what it's all about. But if you are the type that you already know all of this, like, you know, you're already a fragrance person, you know what fragrances do, you know, you're enjoying notes, you try to, you know, break down compositions in your head, you would definitely love this one. And it is a great buy and, you know, a great addition to anybody's collection. I really advise that, you know, you get it. Initially, I was going to say, no, I didn't like this. And yes, I think this is a sexy man fragrance. Like, I think it's pretty sexy for what it's doing, you know. And being a Hugo Boss affiliate, I would call it that. You know, they are doing a great job, and yeah, it's actually very, very good, and I love it a lot. I love it a lot. I love what it's doing. It's pretty, you know, amazing. So guys, if you're ever thinking of a sexy man fragrance, you know, that kind of boss who doesn't want something regular, you can actually get Baldessarini Ambre Oud. I've not tested the amber itself, the ambre itself, but the ambre oud, I'm telling you, you're pretty enjoy it. You know, it's nothing spectacular, but you'll enjoy it. So guys, thank you very much for listening and watching my videos. I hope you did enjoy my video, and if you did, please always comment, you know, like, share my videos. Until next time, keep it right there.
Now you are wanting for the rainy day. Baby, don't.